If you look at almost any airliner today, you can see the genius of NASA researcher Dick Whitcomb.
It's been said that he battled the enemy, drag, and won. His intellectual fingerprints are apparent in the design of virtually all airplanes operating today at high subsonic and transonic speeds.
World War II was raging in 1943 when Richard Travis Whitcomb came to what is now NASA's Langley Research Center, fresh out of Worcester Polytechnic Institute. The engineer was assigned to work in Langley's wind tunnels, where in his early 30s he made his first big aerodynamic discovery. Whitcomb devised the Whitcomb area rule that allowed efficient, practical supersonic flight. He narrowed the fuselage behind the wings to reduce drag and increase the speed of a transonic aircraft without adding additional power.
I had the idea. Then we built some models to try and demonstrate it. We built airplanes with the Coke bottle shaped fuselages, and lo and behold, the drag of the wing just disappeared. Now there was when I was really thrilled. That was a year or two before anything flew, but there the wind tunnel showed that it worked perfectly. It was not some oddball theory. It was a practical means of reducing drag.
The discovery was so revolutionary, Whitcomb won the Collier Trophy, one of the most prestigious awards in aviation. In the 1960s, the aeronautics engineer continued going with the flow, literally. He once again studied airflow to come up with a design for a supercritical wing that delayed the onset of drag and increased the fuel efficiency of aircraft flying close to the speed of sound. Compared to a conventional wing, the supercritical airfoil is flatter on top and rounder on the bottom, with a downward curve at the trailing edge.
He, like the Wright brothers, possessed the most important characteristic of a successful inventor, perseverance and tenacity. He invested a decade of his life in each of his major contributions.
Whitcomb's third innovation was something you can see every day at major airports, those upturned vertical pieces on the end of many airplanes' wings.
That is a little wing. That's why I call them winglets. It's designed with all the care that a wing is designed with.
Winglets reduce yet another type of drag and further improve aerodynamic efficiency and fuel performance. Throughout his life, Whitcomb earned many honors. Besides the Collier Trophy, he received the National Medal of Science, personally conferred by President Richard Nixon, in 1973, the U.S. Air Force Exceptional Service Medal in 1955, the first NACA Distinguished Service Medal in 1956, the NASA Exceptional Scientific Achievement Medal in 1959, and the National Aeronautics Association's Wright Brothers Memorial Trophy in 1974. The engineer was also inducted into the National Academy of Engineering in 1976 for his pioneering research in the aerodynamic design of high-performance aircraft, and into the National Inventors Hall of Fame in 2003. Whitcomb was also welcomed into the first flight shrine at the Wright Brothers National Memorial in 2007. His portrait sits alongside Orville and Wilbur Wright, Charles Lindbergh, Amelia Earhart, John Glenn, Neil Armstrong, and others. And his contributions live on in aircraft all over the world.
These three innovations are judged to be some 30% of the most significant innovations produced by NASA Langley throughout its entire history from its founding in 1917 to the present.
And those accomplishments, according to historians, make Dick Whitcomb the most distinguished alumnus of NASA's Langley Research Center.